I'm here with Kara Nicole, a Power Girl cosplayer. That's what you're most popular for, right?
Yeah, I'm known as Arizona Power Girl because this is my most popular cosplay.
So you're known for Power Girl. What other costumes do you do?
Oh, I do tons. I do Black Cat, I do Black Widow, Zatanna, Superboy, Genderbent Superboy. I've done X-23, X-Force 23. I've done, Shaun of the She-Devil. I can't think because, you know, it's not right in front of me. I've done different versions of Power Girl, of course. I have no idea. Tons and tons of stuff that for some reason I can't think of unless it's like right in front of me.
How long have you been cosplaying?
I've been cosplaying for almost 4 years.
It's really cool. So what are your favorite costumes that you've done?
I love Jason. Friday the 13th is Jason because I get to go around with machete. It's fun. I love anytime I get to do zombies, and I've done a zombie Power Girl, done a zombie Cowgirl for Mark Ronner's Rotten. I've done tons of stuff that I just really enjoy. Black Cat's always a lot of fun. You know, I get to wear claws and be all like, rah, and stuff and things. But Jason, because I get to carry a machete.
So you've made a lot of cosplays. How long does it typically make you to make a cosplay? Or is it different depending on how complex it is?
It really just depends on the complexity. I mean, Shauna is a bikini, and that started out as a pillowcase. And that took me, you know, like an hour, like tops. That was like nothing to do. But then I have other costumes that maybe take 3 or 4 days. If there's any type of adhesives that need to dry or any type of excessive sewing, you know, then it's gonna take longer. You know, I've been asked about my process before. Now, my process is few basic, easy steps. Yelling, cussing, yelling, cussing, cosplay. Like, that's kind of how that works. Like, 3 steps.
That's perfect. That sounds like me. So in 10 years, do you still see yourself doing cosplay? Do you think this is a long-lasting hobby for you? Or?
I don't know. I mean, this really isn't a hobby anymore. It started out, I was just doing charity work with my little Justice League group. We'd go doing Toys for Tots and, you know, children's hospital visits. And, you know, then started getting invited to movie premieres. And that was a lot of fun. And then it was, hey, you gotta go to San Diego. And then the next thing you know, I'm working for Marvel Comics at their booth as a cosplayer. And I'm working for other artists and creating new costumes, you know, for art purposes and comic purposes. And then the next thing you know, I have my own comic book and I'm writing for other comic books. Now I'm an editor for 3 different companies and I am a colorist and I'm a writer and I do media for some different venues and it's just blown up. I don't know if I will be cosplaying in 10 years. I think it does have longevity depending on what you want to do, but there's so much in this industry that you get to do and partake in that I just want to catch them all like, oh.
That's great. What would you recommend for someone who is getting into the cosplay community?
Just do it and don't let anybody make you feel that, because there's a lot of body shaming and a lot of people that just will tear you down. And if they tell you you're either going to be too fat or too skinny or too bony or too tall or whatever, there you will never please everybody. As just please yourself, just always please yourself. Don't let anybody ever tear you down, and don't let anybody ever bully you into doing anything that you don't want to do. So just keep yourself safe and be secure in who you are and you'll be all right.
That's fantastic. This is a smaller con. It's the first year for this place. Have you been to a lot of smaller cons? What's it like coming to smaller cons?
Well, I've done lots of different types of shows. I've done shows in huge convention centers, I've done them in coliseums, I've done them in hotels, and this is a very hometown convention. And what's fascinating about that is you get a lot of locals that love comics, and they love fandom and they don't necessarily have an outlet for it and they don't know that it's available. So, you know, they don't have to drive 8 hours to a convention. Something like that is kind of out of a lot of, you know, your average person's reach. It's like going to Disneyland. It's very expensive, especially if you have a family. So it's great when a show like this can come into a community and help bring it together. And by the second and third year, you have more volunteers than you could ever handle because everybody wants to help. And it becomes such a community-focused experience and it brings people together. And I absolutely love that. It means so much to me to get to be a part of that.
So you seem really passionate about what you do and about conventions and all the different things you're part of.
Yeah, a little bit.
And it's great, I love it. What are some of the good experiences you've had at cons, both in cosplay and out, and just in the...
I have met some of the most wonderful, wonderful people. Everyone in this community is so loving. These people are like my family. We ask each other, where are you going to be next weekend? It's like, oh, I'm going to Vegas. Oh, I'm going to Philly. Oh, I'm going to Smallville. Oh, you're going to Smallville? Yeah, I'm going to Smallville. You know, they have a con there? Yeah, there's a Smallville. You know, so I got to meet at this show people that I haven't gotten to meet at other shows because they're in other parts of the world, in different communities. But then I also have people that I do other shows with. I see my convention family more than I see my own family. So it's a fantastic community, and it's just been such a wonderful experience to grow and build my family.
That's amazing. Well, thank you so much for talking to us. I'm Marie Lim for Sci-Fi for Me. This is Kara Nicole, and make sure you check out us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Check out our podcasts and the rest of the site, and make sure to keep a lookout. For other Smallville Comic-Con coverage.
Thank you.